U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services is launching organizational online accounts in February 2024. Organizational accounts will allow petitioning companies and their staff to collaborate online with a company group on H-1B registrations, Form I-129 petitions, and Form I-907, requests for premium processing. This also includes online collaboration between legal representatives, attorneys, and accredited representatives, and their company clients by allowing shared access to draft forms I-129s, I-907s, and G-28s. Also, for the first time, we will allow paralegals shared access to certain features of our online organizational account when invited by their supervising attorney. With these enhancements, we have made the H-1B registration process and petition lifecycle fully electronic. This is one of many steps USCIS is taking to increase efficiency and transform how the public interacts with USCIS in the online environment. This video focuses on the legal representative experience and is intended to help legal representatives maximize the new opportunities to collaborate online, both with their own legal teams and with company clients. The screen shown in the video may not exactly match the words and layout you will see in your online account because we continue to make adjustments to the account based on public feedback. But the steps we review are the same as those you will follow when using your own online account. We appreciate your patience as we continually work to improve your user experience. You can find a similar video for company accounts posted on the USCIS YouTube channel. One of the new features enabled by organizational accounts is the option to auto-populate the Form G-28 from the data you have entered in your online account profile. Another new feature is that through your organizational account, you are now able to create a legal team, consisting of you and one or more paralegals, that can collaborate in drafting forms online. This feature is currently only available for H-1B registrations and H-1B forms I-129 and I-907. We will now show you how you and your team will be able to work with your company clients. Before doing anything else, it is essential that you meet with each of your company clients and decide which of you will create the company group. You can avoid time-consuming mistakes by taking this first step to establish roles and set expectations for each person who will be invited to work in the collaborative space. There are two ways that a company group can be created. In one, the legal representative sets up the company group and invites a company administrator to complete the creation of the account and add group members. In the other, the company administrator creates the company group and invites the legal representative into the collaborative space. We will go over both. In our first example, you are the legal representative, and your client, Fast Bikes, wants you to handle creating the company group for them. They told you Ollie Smith will be the company administrator. From your representative account homepage, you will begin by going to the My Clients tab in your representative online account. You will see a tab for Individuals and one for Companies. Above that is the prompt to add a client. You will see a reminder of the difference between an individual client and a company client. For the H-1B registration and filings, you will select Company. Additional reminders describe the roles and permissions given to company administrators and members. An additional reminder lets you know that if you create this company group and one already exists for the client, in this example, Fast Bikes, we will send a notification to the Fast Bikes company administrator that indicates you would like to collaborate with them. We would not create a new company group. You already had a meeting with Fast Bikes and you both agreed that you, as their legal representative, will create the company group. You can select Continue. You will be prompted to fill in information about the company, including the company name, the company tax ID number or other identifying number, and the company address. The next screen will ask you to complete the company administrator profile. You will enter the name, email address, and phone number of the individual who will be serving as the company administrator, in this case, Ollie Smith. Once you complete the information, you will be able to select Create Company Group. You will be taken back to your My Clients page where you will see an alert letting you know that you successfully added a company client. You can view the invitation you just sent to Ollie by going to Companies, then Manage Invitations. The expiration date you see in this example is for demonstration purposes only. The date you see will be 7 calendar days from when you sent the invitation. Over at Fast Bikes, Ollie Smith has received the invitation that you sent. To continue, Ollie will either sign into their existing USCIS online account or create a new one. Ollie can review the information that you entered and confirm that it is correct. They will acknowledge the company profile and their administrator profile. Ollie Smith will then accept the invitation. If the information is not correct, Ollie can exit this invitation without accepting it and let it expire. Currently, there is no way to withdraw, delete, or decline an invitation. However, as the legal representative, you can send a new invitation to Ollie before this current one expires. This information is correct, so Ollie accepts the invitation. In Ollie Smith's My Company account, Ollie can now go to the My Representatives tab and see you, the FastBikes legal representative, and your legal team. FastBikes also will now appear in your representative account in the My Clients tab. You and your team can now initiate filings for FastBikes and create drafts that Ollie, as company administrator, can review. Keep in mind that you, as a legal representative, cannot access draft forms started by your company clients in their organizational account. This is a critical point. You, as a legal representative, can only access forms that you draft. This means if your company client starts a H-1B registration or a draft form I-129 in the organizational account, you will not have access to it. Given this requirement, you should discuss your approach with your company client before you start working on forms for them. Let's take a look now at the other way you can collaborate with a company group, and that is when the company administrator creates their company group and invites you, the legal representative, to work with them. You have another client, River City Imports. It is a very large company, and they handle other immigration filings that you won't be working on. They already have a company group, and they are going to invite you and your team to collaborate. The company administrator at River City Imports will go to their My Representatives tab and select Invite a Representative. They will enter your name and email address and select Send Invitation. As you can see, the invitation has been sent and it will expire in 7 calendar days. You will receive an email letting you know that you have been invited to collaborate with River City Imports Online USCIS Company Group. On your online account homepage, in the My Clients tab, go to Companies. Select Manage Invitations, where you will see the pending invitation from River City Imports. You can click on View Invitation to proceed. After you review and acknowledge the information, you can accept the invitation. Now, River City Imports will appear in your Companies tab under My Clients on your toolbar. You are ready to work on filings for both FastBikes and River City Imports. Let's walk through how to add paralegals to your legal team. You can create your legal team, as well as add or delete members at any time. Paralegals will only be able to create a USCIS online account if they have an invitation from a legal representative. At the top of the toolbar, go to My Team. You will see the prompt to invite a paralegal, as well as a space where you can manage users and invitations. Select Invite a Paralegal. Text will appear informing you of the paralegal's role and permissions. In this instance, you want to add your paralegal, Ray Rios. You will fill out the name and email address, then select Send Request. You will be taken back to your My Team page, where you will see a green alert letting you know that you have successfully invited a paralegal. Select Manage Invitations, and you can see the invitation pending with the expiration date in 7 calendar days. Ray will receive your invitation in the email provided and be prompted to create an online account. Ray will go through the steps to create a USCIS online account. There are instructions on how to set up an online account in a companion video if you would like to share them with your staff. Ray will then review the invitation as we just saw in the last couple of examples, and if it is correct, Ray will select Accept Invitation. A banner will appear to let Ray know that he is now able to collaborate with you and the other paralegals on your team, as well as view case status and create, edit, and delete drafts of forms. As a reminder, while you can be the only legal representative on your team, there is no limit to how many paralegals can be added. However, please note that paralegals can be part of only one legal team at a time. They cannot be part of your legal team and another representative's legal team, even if you both work in the same law firm or legal organization. I'd like to show you how a draft form I-129 can be managed. In this example, Ray is going to initiate the draft and fill it out. But first, you have to give Ray permission to work with a specific client. In My Clients, under Companies, you will see next to FastBikes a link to View Company. On the following page, there is a link to Add Paralegal. In this case, we want to add Ray, so go ahead and select Add Paralegal. Right now, Ray is the only paralegal on your team. If there were others, their names would appear here, and you can include them all, or just one. For now, we'll pick Ray and select Add Paralegal. You can add or delete others later. Ray now appears on your team in the FastBikes client page. This is Ray's homepage, and he can see that FastBikes now appears in the My Clients list. When Ray selects File a Form, he will be able to select Fast Bikes as the client. Then another drop-down will appear and Ray will be able to select the form type, in this case Form I-129. The Form I-129 is quite long, so for this demonstration we will advance to where Ray is now reviewing the work. If satisfied, Ray can select Finish and Continue. Ray then notifies you, the legal representative on the team, that the form is ready for review. In Ray's table of drafts, he can see all the forms that have been drafted by the legal team and their status. The draft will appear on your My Cases page. You can see it labeled Pending Representative Signature. To review the form, select Continue Form I-129. You can edit the form if it is needed, then select Next. After you select Finish and Continue, you will then review the Form G28 instructions, as well as privacy and other notices. You now have the option to auto-populate the Form G28 from the data you entered in your online account. If you choose this option, you will scroll through to confirm the auto-populated information. When everything has been confirmed, you select Submit the G28. After you submit the G28, you can notify Ollie Smith at Fast Bikes that the Form I-129 is ready for review and signature. You can notify multiple company administrators if the company group has more than one. Choose who you wish to notify, and then select Notify Administrator. You can now see in your My Cases tab that you successfully sent the notification and that the draft form is pending the company/petitioner signature. The company administrator can then review the drafts, accept them, or suggest changes, and sign the forms. Once signed, you can submit the form and the fee payment. This has been a basic overview to help you adapt to the new enhancements. There are other details that are important in this process that we go over in a presentation that is posted in the electronic reading room, so be sure to view that material when you have time. Thank you.